country at Minnewaska, and you guys just were fabulous. First of all, we were very, very fortunate to be able to have a season. And then secondly, I just think you guys are all amazing. You're such selfless kids. You really understand the importance of being a part of a team, and that is just something that I can't say enough about. You're willing to do whatever it takes to achieve success, and I'm just going to bring up one example. So for our section meet, Sydney C just wasn't feeling her best, and so she actually gave up her spot to an alternate to be able to run, and that just speaks so much of her character and how she values the team, and I thought that was pretty awesome. One of my favorite things about our team is I think you guys are just you're just all really nice people, but when you get on the course, you all were able to put on that competitive face and do whatever it took to win, and that really is something that as a coach is unbelievable, because that's something that's really hard to instill in kids and to be able to coach with kids, and it's kind of one of those qualities that's just innate. Some people just have that will to win, and other people just it's hard to get that, and I think you guys have learned that from each other, which is incredible. The more success the girls had, I felt like the boys just wanted in on all of that, and they just continue to improve meet after meet, and so that is pretty awesome. The boys team, I just want to touch a little bit on our boys team this year. So the boys team really was my project this year, and what I mean by that is I just so badly wanted them to have the success that our girls saw last year and to make improvements, and I really feel like we were able to do that. Our first year, 2 years ago, we were unable to fill a complete varsity roster for our boys team. We just had a lot of junior high kids, so we had enough numbers to do it. Kids just weren't ready. You know, they were young and they weren't ready to run in that section meet against juniors and seniors. Last year, we were able to complete a varsity roster for our boys team, but again, we still had a lot of young kids, and so in our conference, in our section, we finished towards the end, not because we weren't talented, but just because it's hard for junior high kids to compete against high school level kids. But this year, our goal for the boys team was for them to finish in the top half of our conference and also to finish in the top 10 of the section, which consists of 26 teams. And I feel like we accomplished our goal. We just had a tremendous season. The boys finished third in the conference, and the two teams that beat them the next week, we went and beat them in our section meet. So it was kind of a dogfight of a meet. It could have gone any way between us and Melrose and Benson. I feel like, you know, if you would race 10 times, a different team would have won each of those times. And so that's saying a lot about our boys team. And we were fortunate to have gained a few new faces with our boys, and the rest of our guys just matured, developed, and I just think I just have high hopes for our boys program in cross country, and I think, you know, we're headed in the right direction, and you guys really had just a tremendous season. As far as the girls, I really think our strength with our girls team was our depth. We had 10 girls that were able to run 5,000 meters in about a minute and a half of each other, which if you look closely at the section results, I mean, no other team, the teams that beat us, they did not have that. They might have had one or two runners that were quite close, but then there was a drop-off before their third and fourth and fifth runners, and so you know, that's why our team was so strong because we just had that depth. And, you know, you guys just are so talented, and I'm so proud of your hard work this year and how well you did. I think both boys and girls teams, we started out with our home meet. You guys were prepared for that course, which isn't the easiest course in the world. And when we first get off to that start of having both boys and girls team win a meet, you know, you get a taste of that success, and you want to keep going, and you guys had that drive to do that, and that's super. I'm going to talk about our seniors later. I'll come back to that. We're going to get started with our awards. The first award that we are going to do give is our letter winners. And so we'll start with the girls team. And I do want pictures of all of the awards, but since we are taping this, we will do our pictures at the end. So don't leave if you have, if you're a letter winner or if you've earned an award. So our first letter winner for girls is Sydney Perry. Come on up. Tegan Stark. Congrats. Yep, you can make a line, yep. Kira Wilmes. Congrats. Emma Tavares. Congrats. Molly Jem. Sydney Hagen. Congrats, Molly. Elsie Hagen. And we'll do our applause at the end. I should have said that. Allie Fenwright. Olivia Danielson. Sydney Chevalier. Congrats. This one's Liz. Ava Chevalier. Alex Carlson. And Lauren Ankeny. And now we can do our round of applause. Come on up, girls. Congrats. All right, good job, girls. I'm very excited. Oh, if you have not earned the letter, Liv and Lauren, are you the only two? Congrats on your first letter. All right. And then boy letter winners. We have Dylan Strine. Dylan, where are you? Aiden Monum. Ian Mills. Am I saying your last name? Okay, congrats. Make a line, Dylan. Aiden. Ian. Zach Palmer. James Ward. Logan Monum, Mason Tank, congrats, Jaden Anderson, congrats, Jace Kavarek, Nick Ankeny, congrats. Sydney Hagen, Molly Jem, Anna Kavarek, Jace Kavarek, Aiden Monum, Logan Monum, Tegan Stark, and Kira Wellness. Goes to for boys, Nick Ankeny, and for girls, Sydney Hagen. contributed to both girls and boys team successes, and without them, we would not have been where we were at the end of the season. And so our rookie of the year for the boys, we had a tie, Aiden Mana and Zach Palmer. Mana. And for girls, again, no surprise, a tie, Lauren Ankeny and Olivia Danielson.
Everybody
to participate in those summer miles. And then the second thing that I preach over and over in both track and cross country is the speed and strength program. The speed and strength program at Minnewaska is the program we would like you guys to be involved in, because they are teaching the lifts that you guys are using, that you've learned throughout your Phi Ed classes, and we're all on the same page. So when you come to cross country, you know those lifts because you've done them in speed and strength. So that piece is so important, and we had a lot of you be a part of that speed and strength program this year. Oh, Thomas Graham. Okay. Have to add those. So you know that cross country, and I've said this over the last couple years that we've had the program, cross country is about toughness. And you guys are truly, truly the toughest kids in school. And you know what? We have gained numbers this year, and I'm always, always looking to gain some more. So find a friend that needs to toughen up a little bit and bring them with to cross country next fall. Or you know what? If you have friends that are on the fence, bring them to the summer running with you, because they can get a taste for what cross country is like by getting some miles in the summer where it's not stressful training. So bring a friend with to join our program. Like I said, we have some of the nicest kids in the school, but you also know how to compete, so that is pretty impressive. I want to thank, I have an award here that I almost forgot. Before I thank, let's do that. So in our section meet this year, if you were an individual that placed in the top eight, excluding the two teams that won the placed first and second in the meet, you were considered a state qualifier. So if there would be a state meet, you would have qualified for that state meet. And so we had two people that did qualify, and I think when I counted, if I remember right, Olivia would have been fourth and Kira sixth, I think. And so they earned a state qualifier plaque, which is pretty cool, as the state of Minnesota. So both Liv and Kira, come on up. Always do well in the state meet, and so for us to have two individual qualifiers, that was fabulous. The other thing that I want to say, those four teams on the girls' end of things, kind of like our boys in the conference meet, if we would have raced 10 different times, I really believe each race would have shook out differently. I mean, that's how close we were to being one or two, and so just very few points. They're really on the girls' end of things. There were four teams in our section who were standout teams. And there were some other good teams, don't get me wrong, but there were standout teams. And we were a part of that, being a standout team. So that's really impressive. And then I want to thank all of our parents, and I want you to go home and thank your parents, because at all of our meets, I saw so many of your parents, so many of your grandparents. They were coming and supporting you and our team. So they were just happy when you did well. They were happy for the entire team or for other individuals. And so that is something that's pretty cool, because that doesn't always happen. We have some athletics, unfortunately, in our world where people get upset if their child gets gets beat by a teammate. And I just don't feel like we have that. I feel like our families were truly happy for your successes, and that's pretty awesome. So make sure when you go home, you give moms and dads a big thank you, grandmas and grandpas, if they were able to make it to meet. Make sure you tell them how thankful you are that they supported your entire team. And then I also want to say thank you to Screen Prints. Pat and Dan always do a fabulous job for us with our awards. Our girls team, they made the all-conference t-shirts, and so I want to say a big thanks to them. I also want to thank my husband, Phil. So he is kind of my person who grounds me when I get a little bent out of shape. And so he has that coaching experience, and he's just a little more mellow than I am, except for when we play in fantasy football, because we've talked about that, but I know a lot of you are on a fantasy football team with Joey, and I'm also in a fantasy football team with my husband, and he is not very nice to me when we play each other, you know, so you can harass him for that. He doesn't ever let me beat him, even though I have a better record than he does. Whenever I play him, he almost always beats me. And then I also want to thank our assistant coach, Mrs. Mills. You know what, it's just so nice to have a second person helping and seeing things that I've missed, or just taking part of the load, and she's just fabulous with all you kids. She's formed great relationships with you, and that's what being a part of athletics it is all about. So let's give her a big round of applause.
Obviously. queen is obviously Emma for recovering fast and having a blast.
We have the Starburst Award for Caden Mandershide for being a star and always having the candy.
We have our dual sport diamond for Ava for volleyball and cross country. Two people get the Sweeter Than Candy Awards. It's Ryan and Molly for always being kind.
Next we have the reigning 300 king. Goes to Jaden Anderson.
Yes.
Our favorite.
Next we have the best bromance. As everyone knows, it's Mason and Noah.
All right.